So this is pretty much a slow news day. There wasn't actually that much happening right now. A lot of things have kind of died down when it comes to like sports and everything else and all of that. However, there is something that I want to talk about, the whole entire Benzino situation. It turns out that Benzino actually filmed his diss that he never actually written, and he was on location of Detroit in Eminem's restaurant, Mom's Spaghetti. So I'm going to be talking about him and his supposed story. And when it comes to finishing the story, it turns out that WWE doesn't know how to finish theirs. Cody Rhodes. It's just becoming so unbearable to watch now. It really is. Both men are hard to literally watch now. I just want this to be over with. I want this to be said and done with. I am done with the story. And that's pretty much it. And this is episode 27 of the Beyond the Influence podcast. So let's hit the music.
One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small. And the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice when she's 10 feet tall. And if you go chasing rabbits and you know you're going to fall, tell them a hookah smoking caterpillar has given you the call. He called Alice when she was just small. When the men on the chessboard get up and tell you where to go, and you've just had some kind of mushroom and your mind is moving low, go ask Alice, I think she'll know. When logic and proportion have fallen sloppy dead, and the white knight is talking backwards, and the red queen's off with her head. Remember what the Dormouse said. Feed your head. Feed your
So this is pretty much a slow news day. There wasn't actually that much happening right now. A lot of things have kind of died down when it comes to like sports and everything else and all of that. However, there is something that I want to talk about, the whole entire Benzino situation. It turns out that Benzino actually filmed his diss that he never actually written, and he was on location of Detroit in Eminem's restaurant, Mom's Spaghetti. So I'm going to be talking about him and his supposed story. And when it comes to finishing the story, it turns out that WWE doesn't know how to finish theirs. Cody Rhodes. It's just becoming so unbearable to watch now. It really is. Both men are hard to literally watch now. I just want this to be over with. I want this to be said and done with. I am done with the story. And that's pretty much it. And this is episode 27 of the Beyond the Influence podcast. So let's hit the music. I want to do something different. I want to do something completely different and actually talk about something different. Now, of course, I'm actually a fine lover of music. I like music. But when I was growing up, maybe when I was like maybe 9 or 10 or probably 11, I was really... I actually know the hip-hop scene, or the rap scene, as I like to call it. It was when a time where BET was actually watchable, where MTV was actually watchable, and music videos were pretty much running rampant. It told story. I mean, everything was actually telling stories and so on and so forth. But I mean, around like early 2000s, I really got into, you know, hip hop and stuff like that, and learned other various artists like Nas and The Outkast and Jay-Z and of course Eminem. Now, I know for a fact that he has, or actually has or had, a lot of, you know, beefs or rivals, if you want to call it that. And usually he came out on top. I mean, he never missed. Many people kind of argued Mariah Carey took him down, but no, I don't think so. You could even argue that it was pretty much a 50-50 split. But I mean, if he really wanted to go after somebody, he would go after him or her. However, as many, you know, feuds die off and cool down, or just stall completely, or never failure to launch, usually it's one or two things. One, it's all about, you know, the media and hype and everything else, and trying to elevate, you know, your brand and stuff like that. Because most rivalries are just that; they're just rivalries. You know, there's no kind of violence or ill will towards any of them. It's just that who can become the better artist. Or it could be something that is extremely personal that you never will see anybody or any two sides ever come to agreement. Or it could be a little bit of both. I can't believe I did not actually speak about this and like at all, but after what I've heard from, or what I've seen from Benzino, or Raymond Benzino, whoever he wants to call himself, this is just sad, man. This is just absolutely and utterly just sad. Like, first of all, the guy is hitting 60. The guy's hitting 60 and he's still making fun of Eminem. He is still saying fuck Eminem for some odd reason. He's still using the race card. And he's been doing that ever since he had the Source magazine. And he's been so hell-bent on making this man's life miserable. And what I mean by that, I mean Marshall Mathers, also known as Eminem. And the way I see it is that, yes, Eminem does have a thin skin, and he usually reacts to whoever is making fun of him or says anything about him. But I will say this: he has gotten really, really better at just not responding to people and just letting shit go. Which, at some point in one's life, you're gonna have to let shit go. You're gonna have to let it just roll off of you. Eminem, he's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. He's one of the few rappers to ever be inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. He even literally had an alphabetized list of names and unknown names and names I never even heard about, and he thanked every last one of them. So for anybody like Benzino to say that he does not give anything back, or he does not love the supposed culture, Which, let's be honest with you, it's a fucking toxic culture to begin with. I mean, you can't make that argument anymore. And he's literally working with younger talent. He's working with the millenniums, you know, and the Gen Z artists, you know, and there's some good ones too, like Corday, and it's like a. I don't want to say that he's crazy. I don't want to say he's evil, because he's definitely not. He's not deranged. Is he on drugs? Maybe. He said himself that. I mean, he did crack cocaine for years. But to me, Benzino is probably, and I know for a fact it's going to be a hot take, he's literally the most normal person I have ever seen, period, when it comes to celebrities of all tiers, from high to low. He's one of the most normal functioning person I have ever met. The sad part about the whole entire thing is that if he had this much drive and this much motivation and this much energy to ruin somebody's life, which he ultimately failed to do time after time after time again, maybe he should have actually taken this kind of energy and actually put it into his own career. And I can clearly say that, without a shadow of a doubt, he did not do that. He skated by. He thought that he, all because he had the source, he thought that he was actually a known name, and he thought that he could literally go ahead and just skate by on that name alone, and not really apply to himself, to his craft. You know, he could cry on drink champs. You know, he could cry on social media. He could literally cry to the police. The man is not sick. Many people say, well, there's something wrong with him. He's crazy. No, he's not crazy. He's not crazy. He knows exactly what he is doing. He knew exactly what he was doing when he actually hired those ghostwriters. He knew exactly what he was doing when he actually rolled up into his hometown in Detroit. Marshall Mathers' hometown in Detroit. Went to his restaurant, throwing food on the ground, taking signs and shit. He sure as hell wasn't crazy then. And now a lot of you people are saying, well, what the fuck is he? Well, he's just fucking stupid. Plain and simple. He is not insane, he is not evil, he is just fucking stupid. Plain and simple. And now you have people, or actually have rappers in Detroit, literally threatening to beat his ass. Or even worse. Why do you think Machine Gun Kelly never went back to rapping? Why do you think that so many people that who have went up against Eminem were never the same again? Their careers never really truly recovered afterwards. Because Eminem, man, Eminem in his day made sure you're going to be destroyed. Especially if you go after somebody's daughter. But I know now there are a lot of Eminem stands that you can count on one finger. I mean, there's a lot of them. A lot of them. I'm just being generous. He's going to respond. I mean, and plus, I mean, he's still active in the music career. So we're definitely going to have a full album release. Possibly this year, if not early of next year. But it's like, people need to stop giving Benzino so much rope. People are still crying that Eminem did nothing for the rap community. He had done plenty. Plenty. You're just too blind to see. Many people are too blind to see, and then they actually want to give somebody like Benzino a fucking lifeline. And we all know what it is. It's just that Benzino is tied to Eminem, and everybody want prints and views. And what better way to bring on a guy that is literally a former shell of himself, or literally a reminder why you should never go after somebody that who is literally one of the greatest rappers that has ever lived. That's exactly what they're doing. It's really sad to say that if it was literally anybody else, he would have been wrapped up. I mean, let's say like DMX, for example, had a restaurant and Benzino did the same thing. God fucking forbid, he will actually start some shit with DMX. Or anybody else in that matter. The only reason why that he is going after Eminem is because of he is quote-unquote white and he's not straight enough or whatever the fuck he's still talking about. It's just insane. It really is. So we're pretty much wondering whether or not if he's going to respond or not. And I mean, what I mean by that, I mean Eminem. I mean, of course, he is going to respond. Him not saying anything now, after, you know, everything else that has happened, him actually going to his own restaurant and throwing food and stealing signs and shit. Like, I don't understand that at all. He is definitely going to say something, or else, or even worse, something bad is going to happen. I really do think that he's going to fuck around and get himself hurt. You know, Benzino is so starved for attention. Like, I know for a fact that he does not have that much money. I know for a fact that he does not have that much in a bank. Sleeping in Reverend Fens and shit. I mean, what is his net worth anyway? Like, what does he actually have? Did he actually file for bankruptcy or something? I wanted to look at his net worth. All right, so he's a hip-hop mogul to TV personality, and they're saying as of 2023 his net worth is $10 million. No wait, I'm sorry, by of 2024, he has a net worth of $400,000 to $1 million. That's literally like $9 million less than I found out before. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, how the mighty have fallen. So let me clarify this. He was on Love and Hip Hop, right? Which back in 2012, I'm sorry, 2012, it was 10 million. But eventually that kind of went down because he literally fell off the face of the fucking globe. And then literally reappeared in dash cam footage and shit like that. Him having his car repossessed and him having, you know, to be kicked out of fucking Red Roof Inns with other guys and shit. And it's just a fucking like rabbit hole to just to go into, man. Like, what the fuck, man? What's wrong with this guy? What the fuck is wrong with him? But then again, I'll say this before, I shit you not, he is not crazy. He's not even evil. He's just stupid. But you know, I mean, he's just a stupid motherfucker who thinks that he could literally get rich or become relevant again because of Eminem, who is now a Hall of Famer, a Hall of Fame recording artist. That's the only reason why he's doing this right now. Anything else does not really matter. Just for him to actually be known, or should actually be like known or some shit like that. But it really does speak to, you know, his mindset. I cannot stress this enough. He's just stupid. He is stupid and he is self-aware of what he is doing. Eminem is going to destroy him. Eminem will destroy him this year. I guarantee you that. But, I mean, there's an old saying goes that if you're going to be dumb, then you have to be tough. And Benzino, he is not a tough guy. So, as most of us try to watch WrestleMania or the road to WrestleMania, it just feels like it's still a huge cloud looming over us. I mean, I guess you could just say that it really just shows the depth that they actually kind of have. And, I mean, most of these things are just so much of a foregone conclusion. It's just beyond me. I still feel, and I will stand behind the fact that Vince McMahon changed the finish of WrestleMania 39, and that's why Roman Reigns had retained the title. There was no way in hell that Cody Rhodes should have lost that match. Period. Period. So now, this will be the first WrestleMania held after the company that was sold to Endeavor, also known as TKO. The old man is gone. The old man is gone. Gone. Over with. So what does this mean? I'm going to level with you. I really am. I don't feel happy or excited about this year's WrestleMania. I really don't. There are just so many things that they should have done last year, they are doing this year. And it's just that it took us another 365 days for them to actually get this shit right. Cody Rhodes, you could love this guy or you could hate him. But there's a real good reason why that people kind of turned on Cody. It's just that we just can't get behind him. I mean, it's just that, I mean, we just can't really get behind him. I mean, Cody Rhodes is nothing more than a mid-carder who is now a main eventer that doesn't belong in the main event. Does that seem odd to you? And yeah, I get it. He has the music and the nice little whoa and all that other stuff. I mean, because of course, you know, WWE is nothing more than ignorant sheep. They'll just do whatever the fuck they want to go ahead and do. Just to be a part of the fucking show. I mean, they still do what, Chance? In the year of our Lord 2024. There's no redeeming these fucking people. None. And then you have just the blatancy of just The Rock literally just entering himself into WrestleMania. They literally fumbled the fucking bag by having The Rock versus Roman Reigns, only for them to literally be like, oh, you know what? Nah, we're just going to do this instead and turn him heel. The Rock shouldn't even be here in the first... He shouldn't even be here in the first place. He should have been there after WrestleMania. I mean, after that. But then again, I do understand. Like, if you want to run it back to WrestleMania 39, Night 2, main event, rematch, it can't be the same thing over again and just have Cody Rhodes winning. Maybe that's the reason why they did what they did. But in the same time, it's like you're giving Cody Rhodes the Daniel Bryan treatment. Like, the odds were definitely stacked against him with two guys. He literally had to fight Triple H. He was injured. He got his ass beat literally half the match, but still ended up winning. In the end, I mean, I'm glad for Bryan Danielson, but at the end of the day, it's like, my fucking God, like, could they make this shit even more obvious? But then again, it didn't really matter because he was clinically injured 3 months later, and then he had to vacate the title. Go figure. And then, you know, you had, you know, Brock Lesnar. He was supposed to be at this year's WrestleMania, but he got shit-canned because he was referenced in a sex trafficking lawsuit, which that will always be a black cloud surrounding this event. And then after 10 years, CM Punk, he made his return in the Royal Rumble, and he got injured and legitimately tore his right bicep. And he'll be out for several months. So, what do you actually have? I mean, you have Night 1, which is the Bloodline with Rock and Roman Reigns. But then you have Cody Rhodes versus Seth freaking Rollins. Which I don't understand why he... I mean, I do understand, but then again, I don't know why this is happening. I thought Seth hated this motherfucker. But now he wants to team up with Roman Reigns because of reasons? That's all it is. It's just reasons. Then night two, you have the World Heavyweight Championship and then the Undisputed WWE Universal Championship. Of course, Roman Reigns and Cody Rhodes is going last. Oh, and of course, in night one, if Cody Rhodes loses, then the championship match on night two will be held under bloodline rules. Which, I mean, of course, it is going to be that way because he has to be the ultimate underdog to literally fight the system and all that other shit. And I'm like, all right, whatever, man. What the fuck ever. Just get it over with. I want this to be April so I can get on with my life. Enough. Enough already. I mean, we literally need a huge, huge, massive reset. And after Backlash France, I want to see it. I want to see a draft. And I want to see real change. Of course, there are matches that have been somewhat announced. Rhea Ripley, Becky Lynch, do you care? No, I don't. Gunther versus Sami Zayn. I clearly do not see Gunther losing to Sami Zayn at all. Io Sky, Bayley. Of course, she's going to... Bayley needs this win. I don't see Cody Rhodes winning. But I'm going to say he's going to win because it's just about damn time. You don't get The Rock and get anything else and then have Cody Rhodes lose. Fuck that. All right? Fuck it. Just like with Drew McIntyre. Fuck it. Give him the damn title. I don't care. As a matter of fact, those two men deserve it. Then they're this six-pack tag team ladder match. So they have the Judgment Day with Finn Balor and Priest. Then DIY with Gargano and Ciampa. And then they have Awesome Truth with The Miz and R-Truth. And then you have the New Day with Kingston and Xavier Woods and two other teams. Then you have AJ Styles versus LA Knight. Do you care? No. Jimmy and Jey Uso. This is supposed to have been a match last year, but no. Logan Paul. Do you really want to see Logan Paul on your television? No, I don't. I mean, it's... This whole entire WrestleMania is going to be just as depressing as WrestleMania 30. I mean, it's... I know for a fact that they're going to make a shit ton of money, but I just do not care anymore. I do not care about WrestleMania. I just don't. I'm not excited about this. I mean, I really am not. All I want to say is that things definitely has to change, and I know for a fact that Paul Levesque and company, they want change. They want to see a lot of changes happening. Getting Roman Reigns to drop the title to Cody is one of them. Enough already. That is enough for me to literally never watch another pay-per-view until Roman Reigns loses the title, because why the fuck not? Enough already. We have a lot of nothing burgers as matches. There's no excitement with any of them. But then again, of course, the ignorant sheep is going to eat it up. And I just like... Let's get it over with already. Let's get the shit over with. I don't care. Well, I mean, I did say that this was going to be a slow news day, and it really turned out to be a slow news day. However, there's just a few things that I just wanted to go ahead and talk about, and we definitely got to talk about that. Also, let me just go ahead and do a recap on my content creation spring 2024 schedule. I will be streaming live on Twitch for a few hours during the week on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And on Saturday is pretty much going to be way open. Or I should say weekends is going to be way open. I'm going to be streaming probably more than three hours, more than 2 hours. You know, it all depends. Project 11 web novel is only on Roller Road, which a new chapter is going to drop on every Wednesday and Saturday. Alright, so I'm out of here. Thank you very much for tuning in, guys. And I will see you all next week. Hopefully I actually keep this consecutive, you know, podcast going, because I really like doing this, and it will be just a waste of money not doing this every single week. So, in the meantime, thank you very much for tuning in. And as always, I'll see you guys on the other side, and have a good one. I will talk to you all later. Peace.